Dude, we're out of pizza.
I'm on it.
This is how it's done. We're going to be building a real-time pizza tracking app with a web-based front-end.
Alright, so this is the web-based front-end to our pizza delivery app. It just shows the location of all our deliverers. The first thing we'll be doing is creating the Android code that actually updates this map. So in our Android app, we have a basic login activity. All it does is provides a simple form where you can enter, or the pizza deliverer can enter their details. It gets a reference to the deepstream client and then logs in. From here, we come to our tracking activity where all the deepstream related activity happens. So the basic architecture of our app is we have a deepstream list of pizza deliverers. Each one of those is a reference to a record that has the coordinates of the pizza delivery. So the first thing we need to do is get a reference to the deepstream client. So using the Java SDK, we have a factory which we can use to get the last client we created. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is get a list of all the pizza deliverers in our application. And if it's this pizza deliverer's first time logging in, we just need to add them to that list. So we just have a singleton called state, which allows us to store things like this pizza deliverer's email address that they logged in with. Then we'll say our list of users is equal to client.record.getList, and we've called this list pizza tracker slash users. We can then get users as a string array, and for convenience convert it into an array list. If it contains the email of the current user, then we'll add that entry. So we'll just put an if condition here. We'll say users dot add entry. And of course that'll be if they don't exist in that array. So the next thing we need to do is get this pizza deliverer's location record. So our location record is going to equal client.record.getRecord, and we'll just pass in the email. And we also want to set a merge strategy on this location record, because it won't make sense. So there's a couple default merge strategies in DeepStream, local wins and remote wins. We don't want to provide remote wins just because it makes sense that the pizza deliverer's location is the actual source of truth. So next, we just want to interface with the Android APIs and get the actual location of this pizza deliverer. So we initialize our location listener, and which provides a few overridable methods, and the one we're interested in is on location changed. So what we want to do is create a JSON object which we'll just call coordinates for now. And this is going to be the data of our record. So we want to add a property to this called latitude, which is going to be location. Get latitude. We also want to add another property called longitude. And these are the only ones that we're interested here. Okay, then we just need to initialize our location manager, which references that location list that we just created. That's going to be location, and this is just a bit of Android boilerplate. And it's our system service, so we say context.location service. Then just want to use our location manager to request location updates. So we'll say location manager, request location updates. We're using the GPS provider. We want to update every minute or every 10 meters changed. And we'll pass in our the location list that we just created. That'll also give us a warning about permissions, but we don't need to worry about that in this tutorial. Then finally, we just need to update our record with the initial location, because the location listener will only update when we move. So we just get the current location. Equals location manager. Get last known location, and we'll use the GPS provider again. We then set our location record with the same properties we did before. So lat is going to be current location, get latitude, and the long is going to be location record dot get longitude. And that's the Android side of things done. Now we'll take a look at the web-facing front end and see how to receive those updates in real time. Okay, so now we're on to the web-based front end, and all it does is update the location of that pizza icon. So there's a bit of code here already. We'll be filling out the ad delivery tracking, render list, and initialize DeepStream client functions. So the first thing that happens is we just create a map. It's just one of the Google Maps, and assign it to the map div. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is initialize our DeepStream client using the API key that you received when you signed up for your free account. And we can then say client.login, and because we haven't configured any authentication details, we can use an empty object, and we'll get a callback saying whether or not our login was successful. We'll just assume this is true for now, and then we can say our list is equal to client.record.getList. And this is the same list we used earlier that has all our pizza trackers on it, or pizza deliverers. And we can say list.whenReady, meaning when it's been fetched from deepstreamHub, we can call our renderList function. Okay, so our renderList function, all we do is get the list that was passed to us from the whenReady function, and we say getEntries, which will just return an actual JavaScript list of each entry, or containing each entry, and then we say for each, and we'll call our add delivery tracking method that we haven't written just yet. We can also say whenever an entry is added to the list, we'll call the same function, And whenever a pizza deliverer is removed from the list, we can call the remove delivery tracking function, which will just delete them from our map. Inside our add delivery tracking function, we need to do a few things. We need to get the corresponding record from the ID that is from the ID. We also need to add a marker to our map representing the location of the pizza deliverer. So we can get our record by saying client.record.getRecord, and to that we can pass in the tracking ID. And we'll also create our marker, which we pull from the Google Maps library. And it takes a few options. We have to provide it a map, which is just the map we initialized at the beginning. Title, which we can say is location of delivery of deliverer. It's fine as well. And we'll just give that the tracking ID. And our icon is just our pizza icon that we have, just a picture of a pizza. Then when the record is first loaded from the server, we want to update the location of that of the pizza icon. So we say marker.setPosition, and we just pass that the actual record data, because we only have latitude and longitude in there, which is exactly what the marker requires. Finally, we want to subscribe to any updates to our data, so we'll subscribe to the whole thing. And again, we'll just say marker.setPosition of the data that's changed. We also want to store this marker for later, so that if they ever get removed, we can delete them as seen in the remove delivery tracking function.
And that's it. That's how to build a real-time pizza delivery app with both a web-based front end and a mobile.